2020. Before going to begin our session, let's have some icebreaking and come to know what the dates are important in the history. As for India, this is lockdown third phase, the 8th day, same as 11th May, also observed in India as the National Technology Day. To highlight the important role of science in our day-to-day life and to encourage students to opt science as optional for their career and to create scientific temperament and to learn science around us, this day is observed because 11th May 1998, India successfully completed the 3 underground nuclear tests at Pokhran. That is why to observe this day is also called as the Shakti Day or the National Technology Day. This is regarding India. Let's see what the dates are important for the other countries in the world. So 11th May 333, it is said that the great Roman Empire, Constantinople, Byzantium or Byzantine became the national capital. Same as 11th May 868, the Diamond Sutra. It is said the first survival dates printed book printed in China, and we all are fortunate to get the printed survival dates book which printed on scroll in the China. Same as 11th May 1189, it is said great Roman Emperor Frederick I Barbarossa and 1 lakh crusaders, they depart for the Rheinsburg for the third part of the crusade. Dear learners, crusade means the religious war, the war which fought in the name of religion. So it is said in the medieval period in the Europe that 1029 to 1271, this entire series is called as the crusade period. This directed by the Roman Catholic Church or the Latin Church to win and regain the lands from the Eastern Mediterranean seas from the Islamic rulers and to spread Christianity. So this is all about the dates. Next to this, let's see what the green board is giving. Beautiful talk today we have on our green board. It is tell me and I forget. Teach me and I may remember. Involve me and I learn. This is dedicated to one of the noblest profession in the world, that is called the teaching profession. Dear learners, we are continuously discussing from our last sum of the series the discussion about democracy, the origin of democracy, meaning of democracy, definitions of democracy, and same vice versa, the features of democracy. So, if we see the continuous chain of this democratic discussion, we came to understand the one fact that during this last 100 years, our democracy has struggled a lot to gain and link with one of the fundamentals, and that fundamental is the universal adult franchise. So, I am writing here. Universal adult franchise. This universal adult franchise means for all the people, for all types of people, a part of any discrimination should be granted all the equal voting rights. This is universally applicable. Nobody can deny. As the person is in existence, till that the person can cast his vote. So we find that the democracy is struggling. During this last 100 years, nearby 196 countries around the world, they are successfully running with the democratic administration, and they made this universal adult franchise as one of its very strongest features to run the administration a part of any discrimination. So this universal adult franchise granted all the people the equal voting rights, a part of discrimination without doing any discrimination on the basis of color, caste, creed, religion, gender a part of considering men and women. So these most of countries may get one of the strongest basic principle. India is also one among them. But some of the countries they deny this rights of universal adult franchise, but still they are appealing. They are the pure democratic countries. So we are going to discuss some of such countries today. As previous we have discussed about our neighboring country China, Mexico, Pakistan, how under the name of democracy they have completely overthrown the democratic feature and they have adopted somewhat the dictatorial rule in their country. As I always tell you that after all the study you will be only the good judges who would come to understand at the end which are the democratic and non-democratic country around us. So one of the non-democratic feature I am going to write that this universal adult franchise which is giving the equal voting rights to all. Just like the land, some construction, some well. So these kind of things, if it is showing, then person used to considered and granted the nationality, or considered the person considered as a citizen. But here we found that those who were the pure Russian breed people, those who born and brought up in Russia, but for some reason they shifted or migrated Estonia, in them their nationality was cancelled and these people did not granted the right to vote. So these people also did not considered under the universal adult franchise. And third world country is also there, that is the Fiji. In the Fiji, the indigenous Fijians
Party.
same as for the Zimbabwe, there was the ZANU PF, that is ZANU PF. And for this ZANU PF, from the pre-independence, then up to continuing the post-independence, there is leader, very famous personality. He was Robert Mugabe. Robert Mugabe was a famous leader who has been ruling the country. Get punishment. For the individual newspaper, they used to be sent or they used to remove mysteriously. The judges used to be pressurized to work as well as to give the decision as per the government sanction. In India, we found that the judiciary is completely kept independent. We have lot of examples how the Indian judiciary and the other administrative machinery work separately and their complete administration is crystal clear. For example, 1992, when the Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was being fixed under some of the rumors that his hand is fixed with the Bofors matter, and he even was called down at the platform for to attend the Supreme Court at the Delhi. So in India, even some of the fresh examples you can consider as the former the finance minister P. Chidambaram also went behind the bar when it has been proved and found the person as guilty somewhere. So in India, such a crystal clear administrative setup is there. Nobody is there and no one challenges the judicial department. It has kept completely aloof, not under the pressure. Though all the judges used to get appointment in the name of President of India, but once after appointment, the president roles finish, then the judges and with the judiciary used to be completely free and independent to give and to go through with the entire case details and take their own decision. But here we found those who used to publish the news against the ZANU PF or against the Robert Mugabe, they used to be mysteriously disappeared, or against them the court trial cases announced and they considered guilty and used to give the death punishment. Likewise, the complete under the name of People's Party, democratic rule, such a setup was there. So after discussion, these all examples, two of the examples that we have studied here. First of all, that for universal adult franchise, one person, one vote, one value, under this that the Saudi Arabia denied the voting rights to women. As well as in Estonia, we found only the indigenous Estonians, they are getting the voting and constitutional rights, not the Russian minority. Same as in the Fiji also, we found that the indigenous Fijians, they are considered more valuable than the migrants Indian Fijians. Same as in the Zimbabwe, we found that if we consider the popularity of the leader, then popular leader may always not create the popular government. Though, if we access democracy, then we have to keep our check eye on the before elections as well as after election period. Because here we find that ZANU-PF, under the leadership of Robert Mugabe, attained the freedom for the Zimbabwe in 1980. But after the freedom, that he turned out his motives, his morals, and he came down from his values and considered himself the whole soul authorized. Even he took under the medias, even he did not grant any opposition parties for any demonstrations or even the public opinion or even any mass movements or mass possessions. Those whosoever against him, he used to remove them. Even the radio and television only broadcast the news which used to be censored by this, the government under the Robert Mugabe. So this is all the setup. Can we call this as the government features or democratic features? We never call this as a democratic feature. So this we found elections. After elections, then what are the precautionary things, precautions the government has to take to be known and to consider one of the successful democracy among the citizens? If you consider the example like India, or if you consider for the Zimbabwe, then which are some of the criteria that government, when it is going to set up a new democratic government, then which cautious things the government has to undertake? So I am writing here after elections. Number one, in democracy, government cannot some rules.